Hello everyone, welcome to the algorithm course. In this video, I'm going to talk about the merge sort process. So the merge sort process involves these four steps in general. First, we need to split the listed elements into two halves. And then we repeat the splitting process mentioned in step one for each of the portions created until all the elements are separated. Third, we would merge the separated elements by comparing their values. And then I'm going to continue the merging until all the elements are joined back together. So let us see an example of the merge sort process. Suppose I want to sort these numbers. The first step to talk about is the splitting process. I would like to split the list into two halves. And the splitting mechanism is that we can maintain the first half having one more element than the right half. So the left side here has four elements and the right side has three elements. So we can continue the splitting. So for example, the box with four elements is split into two boxes, each with two elements. And the box with three elements is split into two smaller boxes. And the first box to be created has two elements, and the second box to be created has only one element. So we still have to maintain the principle that the left half can have one more element than the right half during the splitting process. And then we can continue the splitting for each of the boxes that contains two elements. So we can see that after the splitting, each box has only one element. And the splitting process is now complete when each box has only one element. Now we can merge the boxes in ascending order. So we would sort the first half of elements first. And the first half is indicated by the left-hand side of the dashed line. And again, the left half can have one more element than the right half. So now we can see that the left half has four elements, while the right half has three elements. Now we are going to merge the boxes in ascending order. So our focus is on the first half of the elements indicated by the left-hand side of the dashed line. So now we would like to sort the first two elements on this first half of the whole list. The sorting process is like this. We need to compare the first element in the left box with the first element in the right box. So it means that we are going to compare 65 with 79. And 65 is on the left-hand side, and 79 is on the right-hand side. Since 65 is smaller than 79, 65 is a smaller number, and it is put into the merging box first. And then we are going to compare the first element in the left box with the first element in the right box. So the left box has nothing, and the right box has 79. In this case, we have nothing in the left box to compare. So the first element in the right box is put into the merging box. So now we can see that the larger merging box has two numbers in ascending order already. And then we go to the next half indicated by the dashed line. Okay. Now we are going to compare the next two elements on the left-hand side of the dashed line. And we also follow the rule to compare the first element in the left box with the first element in the right box. So now we are going to compare 21 with 43. Now we see that 21 is smaller than 43, so we put 21 into the merging box first. And then we are going to compare the first element in the left box with the first element in the right box. So the first element in the left box is nothing. And the first element in the right box is 43. We have nothing in the left box to compare with 43. So the first element in the right box is put into the merging box. So now we have 21 and 43 being sorted in the merging box. And then we can repeat the merging process by considering the two merged boxes. One contains 65 and 79, and the other one contains 21 and 43. The comparison is also like this. We need to compare the first element in the left box with the first element in the right box. So the first element in the left box is now 65, and the first element in the right box is now 21. Since 21 is smaller than 65, we need to put 21 into the merging box first. And then we repeat the comparison process. Now we compare the first element in the left box with the first element in the right box. So the first element in the left box is now 65, and the first element in the right box is now 43. We can see that 43 is smaller than 65, so we put 43 into the merging box. And then we can compare again the first element in the left box with the first element in the right box. So now the first element in the left box is 65, and the first element in the right box is nothing. So now we have nothing in the right box to compare. So we simply put the first element in the left box to the merging box. So now we have 65 being put. And then we compare again the first element in the left box with the first element in the right box. So now the first one in the left box is simply 79, and the right box has nothing. So now we have nothing in the right box to compare with the element in the left box. So we just put the first element in the left box to the merging box. Okay, the left-hand side is merged already. And we can go to the right-hand side indicated by the dashed line. And now we are going to merge the boxes on the right-hand side of the dashed line in ascending order. We also need to sort the second half of elements at this stage. First, we compare the elements in the left box with the element in the right box. So the element in the left box is having only 12, and the only element in the right box is simply 35. Because 12 is smaller than 35, we need to put 12 into the merging box. And then we can compare the first element in the left box with the first element in the right box again. Now the first element in the left box is simply nothing, while the first element in the right box is simply 35. So we have nothing in the left box to compare with the element in the right box. So we simply put the first element in the right box to the merging box. And now we are going to compare the first element in the left box, which is 58, with the first element in the right box. Here we actually don't have the right box. Since there is only one box, we have nothing to compare actually. We just put the first element in that box to the merging box. And now the merging box has only one element. Okay, after the merging mentioned above, we can repeat the comparison process. Now we compare the first element in the left box with the first element in the right box. So the first element in the left box is now 12, and the first element in the right box is now 58. We see that 12 is smaller than 58, so we put 12 into the merging box. Then we are going to compare the first element in the left box with the first element in the right box. So now we are going to compare 35 with 58. Now because 35 is smaller than 58, we put 35 into the merging box. Now we are going to compare the first element in the left box, which has nothing inside, with the first element in the right box, which has 58 inside. So now we have nothing in the left box to compare with the element in the right box. So we simply put the first element in the right box to the merging box. So we have three elements being sorted now. And then after we have got the two merged boxes, we need to merge the elements in these two boxes into a larger merging box. So we repeat the comparison process. Now we would like to compare the first element in the left box, which is 21, with the first element in the right box, which is now 12. We know that 12 is smaller than 21, so we put 12 into the larger merging box first. Then we are going to compare the first element in the red box with the first element in the red box. So now we are going to compare 21 with 35. We know that 21 is smaller than 35, so we put 21 into the larger merging box first. Then we are going to compare the first element in the red box, which is 43, with the first element in the red box, which is 35. Because 35 is smaller than 43, we need to put 35 into the larger merging box first. Now we are going to compare the first element in the left box, which is 43, with the first element in the right box, which is 58. Now, 43 is smaller than 58, so we put 43 into the larger merging box. Now we compare the first element in the left box with the first element in the right box. So now we are going to compare 65 with 58. 58 is smaller than 65, so we put 58 into the larger merging box first. And then we compare the first element in the left box, which is 65, with the first element in the right box, which is nothing. Now we see that there is nothing inside the right box to compare, so we just put the first element in the left box to the larger merging box, so now 65 is put into the larger merging box. And then we are going to compare the first element in the left box with the first element in the right box. So now the left box has only 79, and the right box has nothing. Again, we have nothing in the right box to compare, so we just put the first element in the left box to the larger merging box. So now 79 is put into the larger merging box. And we can see that there is only one box left after the merging process. In this case, the sorting process is complete. Thank you for walking through the algorithm with me. If you have any questions about the video, please leave your comments at the comment section below the video. If you like this video, please give me a like and please subscribe to my channel. Thank you for watching.